Asmik-kun Land is it's a game developed by Asmik Ace Entertainment. If you've ever heard of the game LSD Dream Emulator for PS1, it's these people. So this is one of the other games they made. A little pink guy, his name is Boomer, and he's adorable. And I'm gonna update my There we go. Look at that. It's in it's even in it's even in Twitch's little thing right there. Alright. So we're starting this up. Starting Asmik-kun Land. Asmik-kun. Alright. So I can't read any of this. Trust Super Jail might be able to see what's going on. Yeah, the LSD Dream Emulator is a whacked out game. It doesn't emulate very well, so we're trying to figure out a way so that we can play it on stream sometime. Can I skip? Okay. So, I have a route for this game planned out. You'll see what it is. I'm hoping I don't die, because death is very, penalizing in this game. Extremely so. And there's a reason why I'm killing every single enemy. They drop these little eggs, and you can use the eggs to buy items. And I'm going to need to purchase items at some point for the purposes of this run. Oh, jeez. Okay, well, we're off to a very bad start. Boomer is one of those one-hitter quitters. Okay, let me do something real quick. If we go down to Cell, we can go to the shop right away. I need to buy there's a lot of items here. The one okay is the one that I'm gonna use for this run. It protects you from one hit. And then I'm also gonna see, I get it two up, alright. I just wanna get some lives early on. What I like about this game is that you can enter the shop at any time. I'll go ahead and I'll use one of these. And this will stay active until I get hit. Come here, bunny. You also need to collect eggs for the boss of each world. Eggs are a type of, like I said, currency. They're also your chances and your HP whenever you fight the boss. Oh man. Too slow. I gotta wait for that jammin' frog or alligator, whatever that is. He's wearing shades. He's having too much fun over there. Jordan, welcome to the marathon, man. I am doing pretty good. We had actually a great first game, and we did our first challenge, which was in sync. Get to the show. I'm glad we got something ridiculous like that for the first challenge. I hope it draws in more donations. We do a challenge for every $50 we raise, and after this game, there will also be another challenge, because Jordan here in chat is one of the guys from Zoom, and he's contributed some of the prizes that we're going to be giving out. So I'm going to consider that a donation as well. So we've got a lot of games to give out. Okay. These guys make me nervous. Alright. So every level in this has two stages, or each world, I guess. There's two stages to it. And so now we're at the second half. And after this is going to be the boss. There's a unique mechanic with this level in that you cannot step on any of the yellow things. I don't know why, but they will make Boomer sick, and he'll start hiccuping randomly, and it makes it impossible to get through parts of the stage. You can touch the floor, but that yellow dot, I can't touch that. Can't touch any of those. It's kind of a goofy mechanic, but it's interesting. I've never seen anything like that before. It's unique. It's Japanese. Also, I realized I don't have any 1OKs. I gotta go to the shop and buy some. We actually, about how we got in contact with Zoom, I actually was really, really, really enthused about a year ago that they had ported Mega Race to computer, not ported, it was released originally, but they had re-released Mega Race on computer in a format that I didn't have to fiddle with the DOSBox and everything, and it worked. And I was really excited about that, and I wanted to let other people know. I was like, you know, hey, check this out. If you like Mega Race, I love Mega Race. These people made it work. And so Zoom actually found me, and we kind of worked from there. And now we do games, we work on stuff together. They help out whenever we got events like Extra Life going on. It's a lot of fun. I'm really thankful. Also, fingers are crossed. I hope we get some donations from the Zoom folks. Also, I can apparently stand on the pink thing down there. Not know that. All right. It's tempting to want to jump on the dot right there to avoid the tombstone, but you don't want to do that because it's yellow. You don't want to touch the yellow. Yellow's bad. Watch out for that Mickey Mouse right there. Oh yeah, we got the Gatorbox car in Mega Race. I'm stoked. That was like, Mega Race was my favorite game when I was a kid, and I never in a million years would I think like, okay, someday I'm gonna go host a show on the internet where I play old games that some people have forgotten about, and I'll have like five people watching. I didn't think I'd ever have like the name of that show emblazoned on the side of a car in one of my favorite games. Oh, I missed the egg. They hatch, and there's a little angel inside. It's very sad. Yeah, we got Jordan here. We got Zoom. We got the Zoom guy here. He's gonna zoom, zoom, zoom in your boom, boom. Just shake your rump. Alright. We got boss time coming up. Here it is. Hey, boss. The bosses in this game are very weird, and I don't want to say they make the game not runnable, but you'll see. I'm going to safety save before the boss real quick, just in case something goes horribly wrong, but I don't anticipate that it will. You'll see what I mean whenever we get to the boss. So I have to get to the other side here. And basically, the way this works is it's rock, paper, scissors. So I beat him, and now I get to walk. I have to hold A to walk. He's gonna count, and then he says, let's rock, paper, scissors again. It literally is down to chance here. All right, he beat me. Okay, I beat him now. So I hold A, I keep walking, and now the slider's moving, so I have to keep the bottom slider inside the other pointer right there, so I can keep moving. Shit, he beat me again. Okay. No, you're done. Okay, got it again. So this is very RNG heavy. which is why it's not good for normal runs. Making pretty good headway here, though. Man, he's really banking on paper. Come on, come on! Yes! Alright, so that's completed. Beat that boss. There's 6 bosses. 3 of them are this. The other 3 are literally red light, green light. Which is very strange. Also, I got a indifferent face as a winner. And then we go to the shop afterwards. Alright, I'm gonna buy some more. We'll get some more 1-OKs. And then, just to be safe, marathon strats. I'm gonna get this one. 7-Up! That refreshing taste. Make 7-Up yours, baby! I got 10 lives, I think that's enough. So I'm gonna go, I go down, and then I go up to the right, and I double back over to the top left. That's my route. Because the final boss appears in the upper left. This game has a very interesting mechanic. You see, I go in the mud, and Boomer gets dirty. And then you go in the water, and he gets clean. While you're muddy, you cannot open your menu to use any items. So that's very unique. I think it's a really interesting challenge that... Oh, shit. Oh, I didn't use a thing! Ah. Or no, I did. Okay. Wow, I think when you go in the mud, I think it actually removes your active item too. Oh jeez. That I was not paying attention to. Oh no. Oh, he's burping. Oh man, just barely missed it. I missed the thing. Okay, it's a good thing I bought those lives. This is exactly why. Normally I use the 1-OK item so that I can get through this game, and if I take a hit, it's not... Oh crap. It's not the end of the world if I get hit. It also lets me damage boost through certain parts. Alright. And again, there is kind of a urgency to collect eggs in this game. Ah. Crap, is that funny? Okay. I feel like I'm doing a pretty good job of avoiding the mud, so I can... Excuse me. I didn't get hit! I managed to clip through him and not... Oh wait, no, I did get hit. I did get hit. Let me use another 1-OK. I thought I just clipped through him. Ah. Okay, this guy. Damn it. Alright. This is difficult. Why are there so many of these goofy little crocodiles everywhere? Aw, man. This is really bad. Here we go. Alright. Gotta watch out for the... Don't get hit by tornadoes. Don't get dead. Oh, I hit the tornado! I didn't clear that jump. Oh, we're off to a horrible start. I have not done Mega Race yet. Mega Race is in this block. I think it's the last game before the break, actually. The mud is making it really hard. I gotta not rush. I got 24 hours to do this. I don't need to, hurry. I'm gonna use the 1OK until I can keep it, just so I can keep it active. You know what sucks is that when I was rehearsing this game, this did not give me anywhere near as much trouble as it is right now. I guess I'll take that in exchange for having a perfect run on Tailgater. We can't all be winners. This guy right there. I hate this guy. Like, I can't hit him. Let's see. Oh, I got him. Never mind. Disregard that. That was stupid. I suck at games. Let's just see if I can do that sweet jump again. Jump through the ceiling sometimes. I don't know what the determining factor is behind that. Sometimes I can jump through the roof of the platforms. Oh, just go. Yep. All right, let's try this again. Let's use up another 1OK. It's making me anxious, but we'll do it. Dang it, I'd have to chat. Okay, well the good thing is I used that one, okay. Let me use another one. We're gonna have to make a pit stop at the shop. The one-stop shop for your one okays. Oh! Wait, did I get hit? Okay, it didn't count that as a hit, so I didn't get hit. Good. I'd be worried for a second there. I know if you touch the chocolate on the ground right there, it's slippery. You'll start skidding around. You don't want to touch that. You don't want anything to do with that. Bad news. No chocolate. 100% no chocolate run. And they put that enemy right there so that you'll hit them. They're sneaky. These people at Asmik are awful. Alright, there we go. Risky strats. Alright. So that's the first part. That's the first part down. We're coming up on the second half of Flower, Chocolate, Flower, Mud Land. Alright, real quick, I'm gonna go to the store, I'm gonna buy some 1OKs, and I'm gonna try the extra life thing as well, just in case. Six up! You can get anywhere from 1 to 10, and it costs 1 egg to play, so it's worth trying out. You have nothing to lose, everything to gain. Alright, let's do this. Come here, Birdman. Time to shut this down. How'd I touch the chocolate? I didn't touch the chocolate. Oh, jeez. Okay. Comes the bird. At least that makes me not have to care about my jumps now. Come on. I don't... That's like a little bug, and he looks like a jazz singer. Here's a springboard. Oh, jeez. There we go. Touch the chocolate. That's what it does. Ah, crap. Alright. There's the water, so I can go back and use up my one okays. Everything's gonna be okay. I missed a couple of eggs down there. Shoot. Oh, can I still get this? Okay, good. I just now realized there's giant happy tomatoes in the background of the stage. That's Japanese with a capital J right there. Not because it's a proper noun, but just because in general it's wacky, it's so kawaii! It makes me think of Speed Racer. Okay, here comes the bunny. You must anticipate the rabbit to win. Oh jeez. Alright, just gonna let him just jump and get the hell out of here. Alright, we're up to 26 eggs. That's not bad. As long as I don't get in that Hershey disaster down there, the chocolate secret. Awful lot of really jazzy alligators in this stage. Alright, I'm just gonna let that thing go. Let it go. It's not worth it. You can't hug every cat. Surprise! Oh, he's gonna get me. Every time the rabbit shows up, I get really anxious. I don't like it. As long as I keep my one okay. Oh good, we're at the end. Alright. Grab this. I think this boss does the red light, green light. Boss? Hey, boss? It's time for the boss? It's a slug lifting weights. I'm gonna safety save right here just to protect against it in case anything goes terribly wrong. I'm not anticipating it, but I don't know. You know how the Japanese are. They're wily. They'll throw you for a hook. Rock, paper, scissors. Alright, so this one's a little bit different. I still have to get to the end. But what I'm gonna have to do here is these little pink dots are checkpoints. If I lose, I'm gonna run into this guy somewhere in the center. We're gonna have a rock, paper, scissors showdown. And whoever loses gets sent back to the nearest checkpoint. Okay, good. That's him. So I'm just gonna send him right back to the center, and I think I'm gonna... Oh, no. Just barely. If you touch them while they're on the checkpoint, it'll send them back to start. So... Oh. Ah, damn. Okay, he's gonna get me. And it costs me 2 eggs whenever I get hit, so that's why I wanted to stock up on eggs. If your little cursor falls outside of the thing right there, your guy will lose balance temporarily and lose 1 egg. There we go. Alright. Please pick rock. Okay, that's fine. Try it again. You're making me nervous, buddy. Come on. I'm gonna pick rock this time. Ow! Damn it! I was thinking about scissors too. I was like, he's not gonna play it 4 times in a row. That's statistically improbable. Okay, asshole. You're gonna play paper. Ha. Wonder if he'll do it again. Hmm. banking on that paper. All right, you know what? I'm gonna do scissors again. I'm gonna see how far I can ride this gravy train. All right, so I think I'm gonna knock him out from this checkpoint right here. Yes. All right. So he starts from the next checkpoint. We're gonna encounter again. I'm gonna pick scissors because I feel like he's gonna pick paper. He's not gonna pick it every time. He can't. He can't pick paper every time. Not unless he's programmed to do that. Okay, yeah, there we go. Mega Race. I can't check the schedule at the moment, but it is on our Extra Life page. The time for Mega Race is approximated plus or minus about 15 minutes. Cut it out. Quit picking the same thing as me. Alright, here we go. Paper covers rock. I win. Aw, oh, man. This is a tough part to be in. I don't think I'm going to be able to knock him off if I win right here. Come on. I'm going to go rock again. He's going to pick. I'm going to be stuck here for a long time. I hate rock, paper, scissors. I love this game. This is the only part that I don't like. I think, Jordan, if you're going to be out for 2 hours, I think that should be enough time. Because we still technically just started this game. Oh, I lost. Oh, damn it. No rock, paper, scissors. No. Okay, I'm gonna make it past this part. I'm gonna make it here. I'm gonna eat these candies while I do it. Oh, paper covers rock. Ha! Eat it. Alright, I gotta win this. Here it is. I'm gonna pick Raku. I think he goes to paper after that? Yes! Ha! Alright. Now I just have to get to the end. This is it. I'm in it to win it. Pick paper. Yes. Alright. I think I won. That's it. I beat him. And I get the emote. Blah. Alright. Stock up on some 1-0-Ks. I'm gonna exit. I'm gonna keep those 4 eggs, because if I get one more egg, that's I can afford another hit protector. Oh wait, no, I lost those eggs! I should have spent them on extra lives. That sucks. Never mind. I'll keep that in mind for next time. I'll just buy. Oh god, I'll just buy a bunch of lives. Is that just a bomb just hanging out? Yes. It is just a bomb, in fact, hanging out. Hey, I'm interested to know what these characters are trying to say, if you're able to read it. I think when we play Red Light, Green Light with some of the bosses, I know they start doing a lot of onomatopoeia. Like, they keep repeating syllables and stuff. I can't read Japanese, but if it's spoken, sometimes I can understand it. Sometimes. Being the keyword there. I watch a lot of Game Center CX and anime. Oh, it's that damn rabbit. Go find a level that you cannot be in. Don't come here. don't like you.
How are you?
I like games. Oh man, that's the Mario saw blade. Not quite, but. Oh! Oh, I forgot to use a 1OK! Oh shit! Oh man! I bought all those things, I wouldn't even use the one! And I totally thought that that guy was gonna fly right over me, too. Jesus. Oh well, we get to hear that sweet music again and look at the leaves that look like little fish. Or uncircumcised penises. Or it could just be a poached egg in a little egg cup that we don't have to go dirty with. Alright. I was minding my own business. I was doing really good too. I was like, oh yeah, I got this, don't worry. Also, I realized, this guy attacks in the same exact way as the game we were just the other game, that Charlie from Tailgater. Same way. He swings his tail, he swings his butt at people. Except he has a little poop. He has like a little wind thing. It's not a fart. I like to imagine it's like cracking a whip, and it's the tip that breaks the sound barrier. Just the tip. Come on. Alright, here's where I got glam jammed last time. So we're gonna do it differently. Yeah! He didn't hit me. No, he did hit me. I saw him blinking. Alright. Everything's gonna be 1OK. If I don't collect the egg, it'll hatch, and it's basically. A little angel comes out, and the egg disappears, and I don't get it. I think he hit me again. Did he hit me? No? These monkeys just jumped to their death. What's that? What's the pig saying? He's saying three, but I know that's not correct. See, there's the little angel. Little angels. Oh, I missed. Oh, I still could have gotten it. Ooh. That's what the. Isn't that what Jigglypuff says when you talk to it in the Poke Center in Red and Blue? Or maybe it's Clefairy? It says poo a whole lot? There we go. Alright. Beat it. Part one. Time to use the 1OK. We're in the land of Pocky, Rock Candy, and chocolate-covered macadamia nuts. Something that I find really adorable is that Boomer here is allergic to nuts. If I jump on any of the nuts right there, it does the same thing as the yellow things from the sky level. They'll start hiccuping. Little dinosaur with a nut allergy. I find that gripping and humanizing. You can touch the Pocky, but I can't touch the nuts. No nuts. Oh damn, it's the bunny. That bunny's too cool for me, man. He's coming in here with sunglasses and shit. He thinks he's cool cat. Okay, buddy. Oh man! That's what happens if you touch it. I don't think I have, okay, I need to... Okay, I need to buy eyes, and when I get some 1OK, I can only carry a max of 15, so I guess I'll leave. He tried to figure out where Cool Cat's first suit was made. Someone probably did it on the cheap. It looks really cheap. Oh man, it looks really cheap. But I got glam jammed by that bunny. Okay. Oh man, no more saw blades. This is supposed to be outdoors. Why is there just a saw blade just flying around? Yeah, I get the impression that Cool Cat, his suit, it doesn't look like a fursuit. You're right. It looks like a mascot suit, like something you'd see at like a sporting event or some crap like that. It looks cheap as hell though. Like going by what I know about fursuits, if that was made by a fursuiter, that'd be like, I don't know, cheap, like $700. I can walk through the nuts, I just can't jump on them. Damn it! I don't like the bunny. He scares me. We done? End of the stage? No! My arch nemesis awaits me. Here it is. Double double. Toil and trouble. Alright, 34 eggs. That's not bad. Cool Cat! Days? I'm gonna safety save here again as well. I think this is the first red light, green light boss, though. You see that? The boys kicked out his face! Oh no, it's rock, paper, scissors again. Man, I hate rock, paper, scissors. Look at how long the distance is here, man. This is gonna be a war of attrition. Okay, I gotta beat him. I gotta beat him on this one so I can get to the halfway point right there. Come on. Don't pick rock. Thank you. Thank you for throwing that one for me. It's much appreciated. Will I get it perfect? Will I make it through on the first try? The answer is a resounding no. Come on, Asmik. I mean, Boomer. Okay, come on. All you gotta do, you gotta take him down to Browntown right now. Gonna wrap this up. You bastard. I've never beaten one of these guys on my first try. It's never happened. Never, ever, ever, never. I'm on paper again. Feeling lucky. Okay, I'll do scissors. Damn it! He's not like the other guy. He's not like the other guy. Aw, man. Cool Cat guy is trying to raise money for gun self-defense classes for women. That'll end well. Oh, stop picking paper! Cake Boss! He's gonna run into me and I'm gonna lose his checkpoint. Go, go, go. Okay. Fine, I'm picking scissors first. Isn't he asking like $5,000 for the Van Halen guitar? Isn't that the same guitar he plays in the Cool Cat movie? Why do I know so much about Cool Cat? Stop with the rock. Can't stop the rock. You can't stop the rock. Let me see if he's got a pattern here. If I pick scissors, he'll pick paper, and then I'll pick paper, and he'll pick rock. Alright. Okay. The hypothesis is in the process of being confirmed. If I pick paper here, and he picks rock, then I'll know. okay. The hypothesis was rejected. We failed to accept the hypothesis. Come on. Ah, oh, okay, one more. One more. Rock. Rock. Come on. Do you smell if the rock is cooking? Oh, cake boss! Oh, man. I was so... We were crud. We were so close to Venom. I don't want to pick the scissors. Pick paper. Ha! Joke's on you. You just got trolled. Alright, here it is. Here it is. Yeah, he is. I'm picking paper. I'm gonna win it. I'm gonna take it home right here. I'm taking it home. He's gonna pick rock. Okay. This is it. This is it. In it to win it. Don't move. Yes! Oh man, I hate the boss fights in this game. You know what I like about Cool Cat is that when I was watching your movie sucks, like the Cool Cat fursuit is Cool Cat's mom is one up really. Cool Cat's mom is just the Cool Cat fursuit with the fake eyelashes put on it or whatever. They put like a dress on it. It's funny. Also, can we just address the elephant in the room? That Derek Savage is a huge furry. This music is intense. Also, giant band-aids. Is that a dolphin? What is that? It's not a dolphin. It's a jumping thing. Oh no. It's like take two of the bunny. Harder, better, faster, stronger, hoppier. Oh, it's the mic thing from Kirby. Is that just the purple? Just purple? All the purple? That's all that is? It's a very nondescript enemy. I appreciate the minimalism. Oh man, I'm gonna get this guy. There we go. Well, I just noticed the top man down there. You know what? We're gonna have to come around the long way and get this guy. There we go. You guys reading quotes off the Cool Cat box, whatever? This is finally an important movie with meaning. Never has so much said so little. That's from a Tony Award winner? Did he win an award because his name is Tony? Is that what that means? Because that's not the Tony Awards I'm thinking of. Is it Gatorbox Tony? Is it our Tony? Tony the Tiger Awards. You can't tweet at Tony. Furries ruined that. Gawker made it news. Oh wow, I just noticed the giant lice comb down there, so they're trying to kill me. Oh, the bunny rabbit. Bunny. Okay, we're at the end of the stage. Let me take those real quick. Oh wait, no, we're not at the end of the stage. It goes down now. I forgot about this. Ah. That false sense of security from the lose. Imagine if they're gonna put a bunny down here. We'll never make- Oh! If you ask, I'm sure if you ask the Cool Cat guy where he got the costume, he'll probably tell you some crap about how he married Mrs. Cool Cat and had a kid. And it's not a costume at all, because it's a kid's show. Albeit a very weird kid's show. Shoutouts to Bruce the Bully, or whatever his name is, who just has the phone numbers of every kid in the neighborhood. You can just call them up and just say they're fat. Kind of such a boring life. Oh, vote for Cool Cat for class president. Wasn't that a plot line in the movie where he's like tries to? Oh, damn it. He tries to be class president. Oh, I guess I didn't need to use that one. Okay. You're making like posters and stuff, right? And that bully calls that girl fat. Damn it. I'm not trying to skip all those guys and skip the- he's gonna fall, isn't he? Wait. You doing up there, buddy? Okay. You can do it if you believe. You get to the other side of that Swiss roll. Alright, man. Congrats to you, man. You did it. Just goes to show you, you can do anything if you put your mind to it. You gotta believe! A little bit of rapper for you there. Oh man, this is the edge of the screen. That totally got me off guard. I almost got hit right there. We got Mike. Oh no, the bunny. Doomsday bunny. Remember a decade ago when everyone thought it was LOL so random to copy and paste that bunny and put it in your form signature? Remember that crap? Hated that. Like, I'll admit, I watched Legendary Frog on Newgrounds. I hated Foamy the Squirrel, though. I hated Bill Little Press. They were never funny to me. But I could appreciate LOL, so random humor, but I never liked the bunny thing. Or Bob, or cheese, or pie. That was never funny to me. I hated that. Oh, the bunny! Ugh! Put him in your form signature. Help him take those book records. Crap. Oh man, I was asking for that one. Here it is. Big plays. One thing I've noticed about this game is that the developers do have a certain amount of laziness, because they do copy and paste parts of the stage and reuse them. Like this part, we've seen this before. They did it with the chocolate level too. You know what Gatorbox needs? We need a chat emote of Cool Cat. Ah, every time, man, it's always the jumping guys that get me, because it's... Okay, here it is. Eat it. This is the end of the stage, I think. I'm just getting away from this situation. I've got a million eggs. I'm not going to be able to spend them all. I can't buy that many. I can't buy that many more eggs. Alright. So we're at the end of the stage. I'm going to stock up real quick. I'm not going to do the one-up thing because I need some eggs for the boss fight. Here we go. I think this is the first red light, green light thing, too. Alright. Safety save. I frown upon that, because really, speedruns are a thing of skill, but... marathon strats. I mean, we got other games to get to. I can't be caught up on this game for 3.5 hours. Okay, yeah. This is really simple. All I gotta do is hold down A, but I have to pay attention to what he's saying. I have to stop. I have to stop whenever he stops talking. Sometimes he'll do that, and if he catches me, it costs me 3 eggs. him. So now he's behind me. And he's gonna start following me. I can't let him touch me because I think that you lose the boss fight. You know what I wonder? I keep thinking about Cool Cat's fursuit. I wonder if he got it from like Alibaba or the AliExpress website. Just bought it from some wholesaler and just put a stupid shirt on it. So this guy doesn't give you a thing, one of the faces, he just gives you 15 eggs, which is kind of shitty, but, oh well, alright, well, I guess I gotta spend the eggs on some, 10 up! Also, I spent all the eggs. Usually, I thought it only spends 20 at a time on that, it's weird. But yes, yeah, so you have to beat that guy because you have to get to these two. It sucks. Drives me crazy. Alright, let's use a 1, okay, I don't make this mistake again. Nom 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 nom. I like the Pac-Man guy, they're funny. Whee! More jumping enemies, the bane of my existence. Oh yeah, that Alibaba website has been around a long time. It's for like the when you want to buy counterfeit Pokemon cards. So that's where you go. We use it for Gator Unbox all the time. Remember that disaster of a Thomas the Tank Engine Transformer I bought? I got that from AliExpress. No, I got that from Deal Extreme, but they're a reseller of that, so technically it came from there. Oh, did he hit me? He hit me with that, I think. So I got it from there on the technicality. Ah. I can't believe I got hit by that guy. Oh man, I forgot about that. The flash. Also, the little rice ball down there, he's an enemy. He'll come after you. Look at this guy. Rare. I'm pretty sure the mushroom is also a bad guy. I think he just jumps though. He's a good guy. He lets you bounce. You bounce with it, Roll with it, Bounce with it. Oh! He shot that eyeball off real prematurely. There's nothing wrong with ordering from AliExpress and Deal Extreme. If you don't mind waiting 3 months for your thing to come in, it's a good deal. You get stuff for cheap. Although I will admit, I have one gripe with Deal Extreme. I love building. I built BattleBots. I love BattleBots, and I recently bought a set of gear motors there, and I bought a set of hex couplings to go on the shafts, and then I bought some adapters to make the head of the hex coupling larger. That way, I could fit monster truck tires ultimately on the motors that I bought. Of those four parts, none of them fit together, even though, going by their measurements, they were all supposed to fit together. So just be careful. If you're buying toys, you're probably fine. But if you're trying to buy BattleBot parts on AliExpress, you're gonna have a bad time. Oh man. No, don't touch the dragon, I don't wanna hit the mushroom. Is that corn or broccoli? I'm gonna say it's corn and broccoli because I know what it's supposed to be and it's gonna scare the hell out of me, so I'm gonna fuck it up. Yeah, don't get electronics. Unless you're getting it ironically, like one of those plug-and-play 50-in-1 NES controller things. Those are fun. Jumps. Oh man, what am I doing? I don't even have a 1 okay on. I could have died this whole time. Jesus. Gotta get with it. Would have been a repeat of level 2 all over again. I would have spaghetti. Look at all these jumping enemies. What's up, Flash? Oh! Whoa! Hey! You went all the way around the world to come get me. Oh, we're already at the boss. Oh yeah, don't buy batteries and shit like that from those types of websites, dude. You're burning your house down. I think we're fighting the entirety of Nico Nico video over there. That's who this boss is. Another red light, green light. You keep hitting me with fast moves. Stop it! Ah, right there at the end. 3 eggs. I caught me. That's rough. Yeah, don't catch me. Come on. Ah. So you can actually hold A while he's saying those questions, and you can kind of, because then you'll start walking as soon, like, on the very next frame, whenever it's time to walk. So you can kind of get some extra distance out of it like that. Ah! Okay, I got it on this next one, unless he does his past one. Butthead. Alright, I got it. Can't lose. Yeah. Give me the happy face. Or the indifferent face. Blah. Time to charge up. Recharge and keep dancing with Ohungi. And now it's time to... 9 up! Man. 32 lives. I can't lose. This level has a gimmick with lights, I think, in it. Maybe it's in part 2. Or maybe it's in a different stage completely, but there's another stage that has the level gimmick is visibility. But I can't seem to figure out what it does. Also, the graphics for that bomb clearly do not load correctly. Oh man, ah! Doing it again! I gotta be 1 okay. I keep forgetting. This is amateur shit, man. Now that thing is going to fall. That much I remember. I think this is the first stage it has, like, falling things. Oh, spooky bats. I'm not afraid of those bats. You tell those bats to go away. Get out! Get out of here, bat! Get out, you spooky bat! There's little gingerbread men in the back wall, I just realized. death. Mm. Too spooky for you, too spooky for me. At least there's no skeletons. If there were skeletons in this game, I couldn't handle it. That'd be too triggering for me. I'd have to get out of here. I'd have to call this game off, be a mercy kill. You gotta watch out for the Dreamcast logo up there. They just do that. They don't have very far reach, so as long as you're not going on the top route, you're not gonna get hit by those guys. You just have to contend with the little, the rice balls. It's the easier of the two routes. Alright, this is a tricky part, because as much as I love the 1-OK, it will not protect me from a fall. Oh, did he hit me? He did hit me. The refresh rate is a bit wonky here. It's not, my guy doesn't blink whenever I get hit like I should. Which is weird, because it was totally doing that while I was rehearsing. Aww. Just kinda hoping I can sneak up on that guy. Oh, he's gonna get me too. Yeah. Oh, at least that's the end of the stage. I don't have to waste another 1-OK. Here's the light. I don't know what the light does. It blinks on and off. I don't think it does anything, because it doesn't seem to affect the enemy's ability to see me, or for me to see them. I don't know what it does. It looks neat, though. It's a neat effect. Ah, oh, crap. I think I finally got the hang of this game. I mean, not implying that I didn't have it earlier, but in terms of running it, getting the controls down. The jumping physics and the attack and stuff like that are a little bit strange. They're not perfect. Spooky bats. Whoa. Oh, that's just a big rock. Oh, that's the tombstone enemy. They just recolor them. They do that. As you know, the little climbing foot over there is just the jazzy alligator. I don't think the Dreamcast logo is repainted anything, though. But that little guy is, he's a copy of the little walkie thing from the chocolate level. Nope, too high. Okay, I can't clear the jump on him, so I gotta go around. I got 32 lives, I got 75 eggs. This part's hard. That thing. By the falling candy corn of death, don't want to touch that. Wow, I got that on my first try. The hitbox to activate the little falling things is not what you would expect, so it usually takes a couple of tries to get that, but I managed to do it on my first try. I mean, it's not great or anything, it just kind of amuses me. Also, we're through the caves! The caves are... they have their parts that are tricky, and it's mostly just because if you fall in the pit, it doesn't matter if you have a thing to protect you from a single hit. But, yeah, I got through it. I think this... This guy might be, I think there's one more guy that does rock, paper, scissors. I don't think this is him. If it's not him, it's the guy on the island on the left side. It is him. Damn! Okay, let's just go. Oh, okay, it doesn't matter. I wasn't going anywhere. Okay, paper. Pop L. Let's try paper again. Come on, baby. One checkpoint. There he is. That spawns the boss. I'm gonna go with scissors. I'm gonna go scissors again. Break my stride. There we go. Alright, I'm going rock this time. I'm gonna go rock again. Oh, man. Oh, this is different. It's not sending me back. Actually, whenever he wins, he gets to walk. Okay. This is nowhere near as bad as the other rock, paper, scissors levels. I like this one. I don't mind this one. Don't break my stride, buddy. Come on. There we go. Read you like a book. I'm there. I'm basically there. Come on. Thank you. I got him. 85, man. These other items, they all do things, but, like, I don't need them if I have the one okay. So if there's 11 whole items, or 10 items that you're never going to see in this run, let's just get some lives, I guess. Six up for 60 eggs, really? Really? Right, so now that I've cleared that side, I go over to the left. I do these two stages, and then the boss, the final stage appears right where I'm standing. Oh, this level's bad. I remember this. Yes, this was the one that I hated during rehearsal. Water slows you down, so you have to kind of keep your eyes on the surfboard, keep the surfboard with you, but it's hard to keep up with the surfboard. You can swim, the water doesn't kill you, but it slows you down. Alright, buddy, come on. Jump. Just end it all. Those witches are bad. There is a repainted version of the witches in the final stage, and I hate those enemies. I'm not quite sure what triggers their routine to start dropping enemies. Did I get hit? No hits. Okay, good. I've had practice marathoning games, man. I remember when I was younger, when I was in high school. Oh man, I would. It's a mixture of just having experience speedrunning and just kind of applying it, because when I was a kid, back before I didn't know what speedrunning was. I would just like to play games in one sitting just to see if I could. So I would play through Kirby's Adventure, or I'd play through Super Mario or something just to see. And it was fun to me. So I just, then I found out that speedrunning was a thing. And so I have a little bit of practice. I will say after 24 hours, it does get a little bit taxing. At around the 18-hour mark is where it gets tricky for me, but I have a couple of intermissions planned for this, so I'm hoping that was the same guy. Nope, that's a different guy. It's not the same cheese. I have a couple of intermissions planned so I can get some rest in between games. I can keep rocking and rolling. I will say. where I grew up, I had a friend of mine who was able to kind of, he was literally able to just to skip sleeping and play games all night. So I kind of learned from the best. I do have a pillow where I'm sitting, so it doesn't hurt my ass. That's the only special thing I need. This stage is underwater. I think it's the only one. Like it? You swim pretty fast underwater, but these beans, whatever these beans are, they're awful and they slow me down. This would be, there is an item in this game that will make you invincible for a limited period of time, and it would be ideal to have, but the problem is that you can only have one item active at any given time, so I'd much rather take the safer route and keep the 1-OK active than have to risk it by using the invincibility power-ups in conjunction with the 1-OK power-ups, because then, you know, you're spending twice as many eggs. Because you won't have one act at a time, right? Some over the beans. You just swim over. Oh yeah! If there's too many things on the screen, the witches when they fly across will not spawn any enemies. So that's another time saver. It's a little bit difficult to plan for. See, like right there, the rain cloud got in the way and made it so that they wouldn't spawn anything. So I was able to keep swimming. One cycle out. Shit. Better use one of my 1-OKs. There it is. I'm not gonna be able to one cycle this. Mean bean machine. They just copy-pasted exactly what I went through just now. Can't stand that. It's a fun game, but sometimes developer laziness bothers me. It's one of those times. Here we go. There it is! There he is. Yeah, it's such a sad level. It's underwater, the music's so upbeat, but all the blocks are sad. It's a rhino man, or a hippo, I can't tell because his mouth is it's a hippo. Aw, oh, man, it's one of these rock, paper, scissors. Crap. Alright, here it is. I need this one to get this checkpoint. I'm going scissors. I'm playing it straight. Okay, I'm playing scissors again. Stop it. You make me nervous, buddy. He's gonna pick paper. He's gonna do it. Oh, okay, no, never mind, I got him. Ha! Here it is, alright. Don't break my stride. Rock on. Peace out. Rock on. Alright, that's what I like. Will I make it through? He's gonna walk. Yeah, damn. Okay, I'm picking paper. I'm feeling lucky. Actually, you know what? No. I'm going back. I'm going to rock. He's gonna pick scissors again. Ha! I knew it. Alright, here it is. Will this be the one cycle? I'm picking rock again. I'm picking it again. Yeah, these boss fights are kind of crappy. Oh man. Head to head here. Oh shit, he beat me. I'll pick things. pick scissors. Oh man, you're breaking my stride here, Hippo. Come on. You got this. That's what I'm talking about. DJ Khaled. Alright, if I beat him here, I've got it. I'm pretty sure I've got it. I'm going paper. I'm going paperless. Pick rock. Do it. You know you want? You're gonna pick rock. This is what I'm talking about. Here it is. Oh! Okay, I'm gonna safety save right here. I'm probably not gonna use this. I'm probably not gonna use this save. Come on, just pick scissors so I don't have to do this. Okay, fine. The chat doesn't seem to like the boss fights. I don't blame them, so let's get through this. You didn't see that. I didn't do it. I didn't do anything. He doesn't even give me a face. He just gives me 15 eggs. What a loser. He's the other boss that does that. Ten up! Big ups to me! What I'm talking about. Alright. Here we are. Last world. Or not the last world, but the last overworld and then the final stage. One okay. Good thing I got that 10 up. This world has an interesting effect. You have to recharge on air. You can't stay underwater forever. So I have an air meter now. There are power-ups that exist specifically for this level. They're kind of useless outside of it. So I don't really need them. But it basically makes it so that you don't have to surface for air, or that your air drains much more slowly. Oh man. Took me for a ride, buddy. Oh shit, we got the guy from American Dad. We got two of them. What's this rock doing? He's going up to space? I'm waiting for my clearing here. Very, very peaceful soundtrack of this stage. I will say that much. I like that fish's attack is to shoot his internal organs out at me. Come on, do it. Do it. You know you want to. Oh jeez, I gotta search this. I gotta go for air. It's like that scene from Ace Ventura when he's inside the rhino. I don't know if that counted. Let me get that. So the eggs in this level, I'm kind of doing things a little bit poorly. Eggs are very sparse, and I'm not really doing a good job of getting a whole lot of them. I'm gonna try to. There we go. Starfish. Trying to do a bit better. I'm pretty sure that this boss just does the red light, green light thing, so it's not that much of a problem. So I need a whole lot of eggs, but because I got full one okays. Although I will say real quick, I gotta use one because I keep forgetting that they don't carry over. This music is too peaceful. It makes me want to make up dirty lyrics for it. But I won't do that. That's a DSP thing.
Mm-hmm.
You guys still harping on the word lame, making fun of FDR, man. He was the first half-man, half-machine president. Don't give him shit. He's the real-life Terminator. Although I will say it is pretty screwed up that you had Teddy Roosevelt, who played poker with bears, whatever it is that he's legendary for, and then the other Roosevelt, like, couldn't walk. he's playing poker with bears is not even in the same vicinity of what he would be able to accomplish physically, but I like to imagine maybe he was smarter, maybe he was really good at math and science, I don't know. He was president, so he's not an idiot. Well, I mean, he can still be an idiot and still be president, so that doesn't have near as much meaning as I wanted to have. Political jokes! I got 41 eggs already, wow. Here it is. Boss time. FDR World Checkers Champion. He got to be the best by playing all day, every day. And he's going to teach his secrets to you. Oh, we've got Sunder Shrimp here. Is the T silent in that word? Is it to Sunder or Sunder? Sundre? Am I even saying it right? Yeah, gonna be red light, green light. Never gonna catch me! Sundere? Sundere. Okay, because the other one that looks like Mo is pronounced Moe, right? I'm learning anime. Aw, come on, I wasn't even walking. I wasn't doing anything, officer. Fuck! She's gonna get me. I can't let her get me. The Nazis are gonna win. Oh man, I could've gotten way more distance off it than I did. I got this. George Lopez. I got this! Whatever he says, that stupid catchphrase he used to say. That was not the shit. There's a restaurant near where I live called Raising Cane's, and they serve chicken. And over by the trash can, there's a framed picture of George Lopez just on the wall, like right near where the trash can is. And it makes me laugh every time. That was a stupid catchphrase. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna pick a random one. 5 up. Not bad. 52 lives, one for every card in the deck. There we go. The big sleeping fox, dragon, whatever that is. Big sleeping animal. So this one takes place in space. Okay, I'm forgetting the biggest thing. See the little rocket thing down there? You know what that is? That's that friggin' rabbit. That's that stupid rabbit. The plane, that's the witch. So they're putting my two least favorite enemies in this stage together, and I just got hit. So that little chompy thing, we haven't seen him since the very first stage. He shoots out the little balls. That's it. These little worms are a repaint of the Jazzy Alligator. And then we just saw the little monkey from the picnic stage as well, who came back. And that little thing down there is that little thing that had the little red eyeball that shoot out. They're basically bringing back all the enemies. Did I get hit? I did get hit. Ah. Okay, good. That's the Flash. Oh, no, that's the monkey guy. Never mind, I'm dumb. Dick statues? Those are swords, they're not dicks. Although, now that you say that, the hilt of the sword, the handle right there, I'm not gonna unsee that. That's totally two balls and a dick. This level brought to you by Bad Dragon. Aw, oh, man, he barely grazed me. Aw, oh, jeez, I'm getting glam jammed out here. Spending these eggs faster than I can earn them. Did he hit me? I can't tell. I don't think he did, because I still have my wallet hit. Ah! Guy with the eye. Look, there's a monster guarding that dick statue. Shooting acorns at me or whatever. Oh no, the money. Skip that part. Don't mind me. Oh, they're the big plays. There it is. Oh, man. Oh, this is... Will I make it? No, without getting hit. Will I make it? Wow. I did it. So there's only one part to that. Let me go straight to the final boss. It's, evil, I don't know what that is. Doesn't look like the thing that was sleeping on the map screen, but whatever. Please don't make me play Rock, Paper, Scissors. I don't remember what the final boss does. He talks a lot, that's what he does. Red light, green light? God. We're almost there. Almost done. Aw, man. I'm tempted to just hold the thing down and just take the penalties, but I don't know, yeah, I don't know if I'd be able to make it if I did that. Ah, come on. Alright, Dr. Anime, come on. You're gonna take me alive. Never for my life. I think I'm at the point where I can just say screw it, just hold down A. He's not gonna get me. I'm not gonna let him get me. There it is. Maze? So that's a wrap on Asmik-kun Land. Beat him. I can't tell you what the story was, I just beat everything. Look, everyone's partying, we did it! Nope, they're leaving. Party's over. Oh man, alright. That's a wrap on that. Let me check our donations. Get those pulled up. Thank you. I tip my fedora to you. Thank you for the compliments. Alright, we are still at $82.14. So that's pretty good. Our goal this year is $300. And again, for every 50 bucks we raise, every 50 bucks we do a challenge. So if you guys want to see more shit like NSYNC, help NSYNC get to the concert wherever it was, we got more of those. I'm gonna do at least two more challenges throughout the marathon, just because of all the prizes that have been donated by Zoom platform. I figured that's worth it.